Good morning students, welcome back to your SST online class. Today we are going to start with the second chapter of geography, which is globe, latitudes and longitudes. Okay, so first of all we are going to discuss about what is globe. Let's discuss about globe. As you can see in this picture also, it is flattened at the poles, north pole and south pole, but it is bulge in the middle. Bulge means round, sort of round in the middle. So as you are looking at it, you must be feeling like it's like a small earth. Okay, it is like a true model of the earth. So globe is a true model or miniature form of the earth. Miniature form means just like a small form or a miniature. Miniature in general means small, right? Any small form of anything, right? So globe is the small form of earth. Globes may be small or they may be big ones. They may be of different size as well as type, right? The smaller ones are easily, you can carry them, and the smaller ones are like pocket globes. They can be, they are just like balloons, small balloons. They can be carried anywhere easily, right? Okay, so globe is not fixed, can be rotated like a spinner. As you all might be knowing, we are having spinners now as toys. So it is just like a spinner. It can be, you know, rotated, right, like a potter's wheel. Okay, and on the globe we can see all our countries, continents and oceans in their correct size. Got it? Now there is a needle that is fixed through the globe in a tilted manner. Tilted manner means slanting manner, slanted way, not straight. Okay, and that needle is said to be the axis, right? Okay, two points on the globe through which the needle passes are which poles? North pole as well as south pole. I have already explained this to you in the previous chapter. At the top it is north pole, and below, and that means the lowest point, is the south pole, right? So there is a needle which is said to be the axis, right? Although it is to be remembered that real earth has no such needle. Real earth mein aisa kuch needle nahi hota hai. It's just in this globe that is shown that such needle represents what? Axis, jiske around earth rotate karti hai, right? Okay, now there is an imaginary line running through the globe. Ek imaginary line hoti. Imaginary means which is not real, which runs through the globe, and that line is known as equator. As you can see in the picture also, an imaginary line is there which is called equator, and it divides, very important that it divides the earth into two equal parts. Two equal parts mein divide karti hai ye earth ko, right? The upper part is northern hemisphere, the lower part is southern hemisphere. And it is very important to know that equator divides the globe or the earth into two equal halves. Equal hai northern hemisphere also and southern hemisphere also. Got it? So the next thing we are going to study about is latitudes. Now what do we mean by latitudes? Latitudes are the horizontal lines. As you can see in the diagram also, these are the horizontal lines which are moving from equator up to the poles, that means to the north pole and south pole, right? So are the lines, right? These are the lines, horizontal lines, which are moving towards the north pole, as you can see in the picture also, right? Now what are the parallels of latitudes? Achha, you might be knowing about parallel lines. These are the lines which never intersect. You must have studied in your maths, right? Same way, these are the parallel circles. They never intersect. These circles never intersect. So all these parallel circles from equator up to the poles are called parallels of latitudes, and latitudes are always measured in degrees. Like you have angles na in maths, same way they are measured in degrees, right? Okay, and they are very important to find out the location of any particular place. Very important lines or the circles, parallels of latitudes. And you all might be knowing that equator represents 0 degree latitude. Jo equator hota hai, hamesha uska degree kya hota hai? Zero. 0 degree latitude represent karta hai. Got it? Now, the distance from equator to either of the poles, either means either north pole or south pole, is 90 degree. What is the distance? It is 90 degree. Okay, thus 90 degrees north latitude is north pole and 90 degrees south latitude is south pole. Got it? So north pole is 90 degree N, that is not 90 degree north, and south pole is 90 degree S, that is 90 degree south. Now all such parallels north of the equator are north latitudes, and the parallels or the parallel circles south of the equator are south latitudes. Got it? And they are always denoted by N or S. North latitudes by N and south latitudes by S. Now we are going to study about important parallels of latitudes. So there are some important parallels of latitudes. So there are four major parallels of latitudes: Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle. Okay, since we all know that equator is 0 degree and north pole is 90 degree north and south pole is 90 degree south. So these four major important latitudes are also there. You all should know their names along with their degrees, right, along with their positions. So Tropic of Cancer is 23 degree north, 23 and a half degree north in the northern hemisphere. Tropic of Capricorn is 23 and a half degree south in the southern hemisphere, and Arctic Circle at 66 and a half degree north, and Antarctic at 66 and a half degree south. These are the major parallels of latitudes. These four are the major parallels of latitudes. Now we are going to study about the different heat zones of the earth. Right, there are three main heat zones of the earth, which are torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. Right, so let's talk about them in detail. First of all, let's come to torrid zone. Just see, so all the latitudes lying between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn are covered in this zone. This is the area which receives maximum heat. So torrid zone is the area which receives maximum heat. So which is torrid zone? The areas or the latitudes that come under Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn are covered in this torrid zone, which receives the maximum heat. So now the next zone we are going to talk about is temperate zone. Temperate zone kya hota hai? Now just see in the diagram also. So the areas bounded by Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle in northern hemisphere and Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle in southern hemisphere are temperate zones. Okay, and these zones are called temperate zones because here it is moderate temperature. It is neither too hot nor too cold. Right, zyada garmi bhi nahi hoti, zyada sardi bhi nahi. Now the third zone is frigid zone, and this zone is very cold. Right, so where is frigid zone? Frigid zone lies between Arctic Circle and North Pole in northern hemisphere and Antarctic Circle and South Pole in southern hemisphere. And why is frigid zone so cold? Because near the poles sun rays could not reach. Okay, and the sun rays are always slanting, and this is the reason why the frigid zones are very cold, because towards the poles sun rays cannot reach. That's why the pole areas are very very cold. You all must have heard that the areas near the poles, jo bhi areas north pole ya south pole ke aas paas hote hain, they are very cold, because you know sun rays reach nahi kar pati hai north pole aur south poles pe. That is the reason these frigid zones are very very cold. So three zones we have discussed: torrid zone, which is heat zone, maximum heat; temperate, moderate temperature; and frigid zone is the cold zone. Right, so these three zones we have discussed. So now I want you all to read what are longitudes. In the next class we are going to study about the longitudes. Got it, everyone? And just make sure that you go through all the pages that we have done, all three pages, and go through all the definitions. We'll discuss the next topic in the next class. Thank you.